So myself, Samantha Kumar, Assistant Professor, Regulatory Department, Field Management Engineering College. So in this semester, I'm going to teach the basic electrical and electronic subject. So in this subject, I'm going to teach one important topic, that is for the circuit, that is a mesh analysis. That is mesh analysis. So first we have to see what is the mesh analysis. So the mesh analysis means ABL plus Ohm's law. ABL plus Ohm's law. Kirchhoff voltage law is Ohm's law. Kirchhoff voltage law is Ohm's law. Now we see what is the mesh analysis. How do we remember ABL and Ohm's law? So if we have the complicated circuits, if we have the complicated circuit, we cannot apply this Ohm's law by KVL degrees only. If we have the complicated circuit, we does not apply KVL either KVL or Ohm's law individually. So that is why we are going to club those two methods, those two laws. So by clubbing those two laws, we will go for the new analysis, that is what? Mesh analysis. This is the mesh analysis. So how we apply the mesh analysis? Because of simplify the circuit analysis. What is the meaning of circuit analysis? Circuit analysis means what? Whatever the circuit consists. Circuit in our electrical circuit. The circuit consists voltage, current, power, resistors, and all of that. So in this we have to find whatever the current going through the resistor or branch, whatever the voltage across the branch, whatever the power consumed by the branch. So we have to find all those things. We have to follow these methods, mode analysis, mesh analysis, these are the most two important things. So now apart from I have chosen mesh analysis. So now first we have to see how to apply the mesh analysis. The procedure to follow. What steps? Steps to follow. What are the steps we are going to follow? First step. Step one. First step. Step one. Step one. So whatever the circuit we have, first we are going to find number of loops in the circuit. Loop means what? It is a closed path. It is a closed path. So where it starts, it should be end at that point only. Where it should be start, it should be end at same point only. That is the loop. So like that, how many number of loops are there in the circuit? First we have to find the number of loops in the circuit. Number of loops in the circuit. That's the first thing. Next, step two. So after finding number of loops, we have to indicate the loop current direction. Indicate loop current direction. How the current is traversal in that particular loop. So we have to indicate the loop current. How we indicate the loop current? So we can assume that the current flowing from upper polarity to lower polarity. So the current flowing from upper polarity to lower polarity. So the upper polarity means what? Positive. Lower polarity means what? Negative. So this is our assumption only. If you want, you can assume reverse. The current is flowing from negative to positive, also there is no problem. So that is your assumption. Why we assume like that? Because of because of simplify the analysis, because of simplify the complexity. Simplify the complexity. So now we know that number of loops in the circuit and loop currents. How the currents are flowing in the particular loop. This two are important. Next step three. Now this is our main point is coming here. Apply. So already we know the loops and loop currents. Now we can apply the KVL. Apply the KVL in the loops. Apply KVL in the loops. What is the KVL? The algebraic sum of voltages in a loop is equal to 0. The algebraic sum of voltages in a loop is equal to 0. So that is the law applying the all the loops. So next step 4. What is the step 4? Write the loop equations. Write the loop equations. Now final step. What is the final step? Step 5. Solve the loop equations. To find required value. So these are the steps to follow the or to apply the KVL in a circuit. To apply KVL in a circuit. So these are the steps. So first step is what? We have to find the number of loops in the circuit. And next, we have to indicate the loop current direction. Then how can we indicate the loop current direction? We have to assume that loop current direction from upper polarity to lower polarity. So I can imagine that the current should flow from positive to negative. Okay, if you want, you can assume that negative to positive. So next is what? And now we can apply the KVL in the loop. Apply the KVL in the loop. And next step, we have to write the loop equations, and finally by solving those loop equations we can get whatever the required value, whatever we want. So these are the steps. So now we will take your class as an example, and we have to apply this mesh analysis to find currents or voltages, whatever we want. So we can go through the See, I am going to take a second. If suppose the circuit consists two voltage sources, one has a 50 volts, one 2 volts, and this branch has a 4 volts, and this branch has a 6 volts, and this is one more voltage source which has delivered the 25 volts, which delivers 25 volts. This is the one circuit. This is circuit we have. So now, by applying the mesh analysis, I want to find the current. I want to find current flowing through the 4 volts. I want to find current flowing through the 4 volts. So that, what is the difference? So first, we have to find the loops. How many loops are there? So first we have to indicate the loops. So first I have to indicate that where the points A, B, C, D, E, these are the points. So these are the points. So now how many loops are there? One loop is what? If we assume that starting at A, B, E, F, A. One loop is what? Step one. Find number of loops. Step 1. So loop 1. First loop is what? A, B, E, F, A. And second loop is what? B, C, D, E, B. B, C, D, E, B. So now we can also check that another book A, B, C, D, E, F, A. But it is not comes under mesh analysis. Right? Because it is not mesh. What is the difference between the loop and mesh? The mesh does not consist another loop in that. The mesh does not consist another loop in the mesh. Okay? So that is why we are not going to take this entire loop. So there are only two loops. There are only two loops. Now next we have to step 2. Loop current direction. Loop current direction. Indicate the loop current. So from positive to positive to negative. So this is the positive current and we have to indicate this current. This is I1. So whatever the how many loops are there? Those loops should be follow the same direction. It is what? I2. Right? I2, I1 and I2. Okay. So next step. See, now we have to apply KVL. Apply KVL. Apply KVL in loop 1. In loop 1. So loop 1 is what? In loop A, B, E, F, E. You can apply the KVL in loop A, B, D, KVL. So, what is the equation is there? So, we can always consider the leading polarity. If you want, you can consider the starting polarity also. So, for the sake of simplicity, I can consider the leading polarity. So, this all these branch, so all these branch elements resistors, which consists the polarities of voltage. Prevents the okay, so all these things. So now we can apply that. So this is a leading one is 40, positive, that is what? That's 50. Next. So now we have to write the equations for the voltage. That voltage V is equal to what? I into R. So now what is the current flowing from the resistor? 2 ohms. That is current is I1. So then what is the value? 2 ohms. So R is equal to I1. That is the voltage across the 2 ohms. So next the current is like this. So next is what? Minus 4 I1. So now we can observe here in this particular branch, the current is there are two currents are flowing through this branch. One is this direction, then another one is in opposite direction, that is the I2. That is what? I2, that is plus 4 I2. Why plus? Because of opposite. Now we can solve the equation, that is 50 minus 6 I1 plus 4 I2 is equal to 0. Equation number 1. Now applying KVL in loop 2. That is what? B, C, D, E, F. B, C, D, E, F. B, C, D, E, F. Now what we get? Minus 6 I2 minus 25 minus 4 I2 plus 4 I1 is equal to 0. Now I can simplify this one. Minus 25 minus 6 I2 plus 4 I1 is equal to 0. So now we can simplify these equations. 6 I1 minus 4 I2 is equal to 50. Equation number 1. Now from this equation 4 I1 minus 6 I2 is equal to 50. Equation number 1. So by solving these two equations, we can get the I1 value and I2 value. So if I want to solve this equation, if I want to find, we can find the I1 and I2. So after finding I1 and I2 and I2, we can apply in this formula. So that means what? The I1 and I2 should opposite. I1 and I2 should opposite. That is what? Those two are opposite. That is what the resultant current is what? I1 minus items. So like this, we can follow the mesh analysis.